Well, that's fantastic. A really smart decision, young man. I'm going to go ahead and take your paycheck right here. I'm going to deposit it into your account. One moment here. I'm going to take your paycheck, move it into a few shares of GoPro. Okay. All right. And then we're going to move it into Digibyte. All right. And back into Terra Luna. And it's gone. It's all gone. And holy smokes, cue the fire. So you out there, whether you are getting laid off or your house is a complete dumpster fire or you are paying $34 for a bag of chicken wings and we are going to lose a lost decade in stocks, it is okay because Johnny Bravo come here to save the day. But if you could throw me a life preserver, save the channel by clicking that like button. I save you, you save me, we row together. So aren't you guys excited? El-Erian, that is Mohammed. Smart guy. Even though you guys are like, did you see the trade he just made? It was horrible. I don't know. I don't know what he did. He says U.S., which I'm going to agree with him, cannot, I'll underline this, can't avoid stagflation. And trust me, the Fed governments, they don't know how to fix stagflation unless you want 1 basis point, 2 basis points, 3. You got to really shock the market, even as Fed tightens. And I don't know if you guys know me, which you kind of do know me. I like tight, but just not too tight. In my pants, I'm like, ugh, I can barely breathe. These things are so tight, but they make my booty look good. So I'll take it. Stagflation is worst thing for central banks. Markets still price in significant economic slowdown. And I don't know if you've been in the market today, but market's not good. Also known as, and it's gone. Hopefully you guys exit, remember? Exit prior to earnings. So any of you guys holding Target, well, you just lost an entire finger, which I guess is not as bad as losing your entire job, which Netflix lays off another 150 employees amid subscriber loss. Have you seen Netflix's stock? Yeah, they're gonna be leaving the fangs. Yes, the N is going to go bye-bye. I mean, geez, I wonder if looking at that Netflix chart, if I could just turn on one line. Also, for those of you that are looking at this, see where it goes brown, okay? When it's brown, don't flush it down. That's when you take profits. But wait, that actually works. Click the sell button. Yes, when it's brown, flush it down. Okay, great. Unless your last name's Brown, then you're okay. I'm going to turn on one line, and it is blue. Ta-da! See that? See that little blue line? Right, exit. When you're under that. Could have probably saved you a whole lot of money on that Netflix trade. Imagine if you would have, right? When it's brown, flush it down. How much money you would have made? Let's take a look at Target. T-A-R-T-G-T. There it is. See? And it's gone. I mean, you must be so frustrated at yourself. If you know how to trade, I would be kicking myself in the rear. Look at this. See, this is called a double top. What happens after a double top? It sells off. What is this? This is, right? When it's brown, take profit. Click the button. Make some money. And then, look. Earnings. Earnings, you exit before you lose all of your fingers. I mean, from the top of this market, holy smokes, down to where we're at right now, 41% no. And I actually just got really excited, my TLT trade. I thought it was 15%. I'm like, what? No, that is the VIX. Also, let me show you on the VIX. There is a line. See that blue line up there? You don't want to cross that blue line. We're currently at 30. You hit 36, liquidity gone, market, whoa. So let me show you, let me pull back a little bit. 36, you either get rejected, which I'm okay with that, or all hell breaks loose. You can also trade this, but on this trade, you're gonna wanna get in and get out. No, do not hold over the weekend, do not hold overnight. Also the Dixie, that's the dollar, or UUP if you want to trade it. These are your profit-taking zones. That's couple days ago, and let me explain this. And I'm gonna try to keep it really simple, okay? Number one, they taught you wrong in college. I know, shocker, right? They taught you wrong in high school. Not a shocker. And I know this because I taught it, and they gave me the books. I'm like, this isn't right. Now, why the strength of the dollar, and then everything gets wrecked. Everyone's like, oh, it's this and it's that. And I don't want to tell you what the this and that is, because then I'm going to make your noggin get confused. Okay, let's start from scratch. Where does money come from? It comes from the banking system. It's debt loans. Which I know, that already confuses people. Watch, I walk into the bank, huh? And I say, hey, I want a loan. The bank has no money. They're like, how much? Johnny Bravo? I say, 1 million. They're like, we got ya. Here's a check for 1 million. Poof, just got created. And the bank doesn't even have 1 million. I know, crazy. But I have to pay them with interest. But we just created $1 million into the financial system. Guess what banks are not doing right now? They're not doing loans. So guess what's happening? Supply and demand. There is no dollars. Also known as lack of liquidity. That's what people will say. Also, if you want to see it, the M2, you want to see how much that those dollars in the system have been moving around since 1998, 1996? They're not. And you want to see what Fed Gobert did? Right there. Not good. So what do we need to do? We need to produce dollars for the entire system. But the Fed's like, no, this is a bad idea. We're going to tighten. And I say, Jerome, that's a bad idea. You shouldn't do that. You're going to crash the whole system. And really soon, the Fed's going to realize, wait, this didn't work. No, Jerome, it didn't work. This time, it didn't work. Just loosen it. Just let this thing burn down to the ground. Cue the fire, because in the end, that's what's going to happen. This whole system. And I know, the dollar, it's horrible. The Keynesian atheism system of debt out of money, out of nothing, does not exist, is not going to bode too well. And I'm down with you if you want to be agnostic, atheist. I don't care. Just don't be an idiot. This is him right here. 1933. He was not born in 33, but he experienced 33. Yes, he did. He was born in 1883. And this is the Lord Keynes, and this is where the system is created from. But because we are in a system that is completely broke, it's 1971, if you want to chart it. that is where all hell broke loose. Why is that? It's because of gold, okay? Now, we need to... There's no such thing as inflation gold. That's it. That's all you got. And when this whole thing breaks, oh yes, gold and silver will be worth quite a bit of money, because it is money. But the only question I cannot answer is when. So in the meantime, I am just going to play the game that is in front of me. I look at the charts that are in front of me, and I trade that, and I use that to buy things that I want. But if I sit there with my fingers in my ear and go, no, 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 la, 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 this is how it, I'm going to be broke. And so will you if you don't understand this. Look, chicken wings for 34 bucks. Sorry, I jumped the gun a little bit. Pent-up inflation will drive U.S. food costs even higher. So your entire life, inflation, deflation, inflation, deflation, depends on where you live. Hyperinflation, right? This is not good. Milk up 25%. Bacon up 35%. Yes, because we're on the inflation side. We're in the bubble gets blown, but when the bubble pops, deflation. Also, if you know how to trade these things on inflation, deflation, right? Bubble blows up, bubble pops. Blows up, pops. Pops, you buy. Blows up, you sell. Pops, you buy, right? You get it. And here's a chart. And for those of you that trade Bitcoin or Bitcoin, and for all those of you that I offend every time I say that, take a look at Grayscale. If you want a discount on the fake Bitcoin, just like the fake Bitcoin you'd get on Robinhood, just like the fake Bitcoin you'd get on Webull, all of those are fake. You actually have to go to the exchanges to get real. Real would be me mining it, me figuring out the code. I get the code and I transfer it to a wallet, my wallet or your wallet, and it has a passcode or a 10-word phrase that you put into your wallet, and you're like, oh, it's unlocked. You can take $250 billion, well, Bitcoin, code, and go to China and type in, oh, it's all here. It's very nice. Gold and silver gets a little heavy carrying on the plane. But trading, if you ever want to trade the fake stuff, number one, this is on sale. It's 18 bucks, but it's going to go lower. It's going to go to that little gray bar. And if you want to learn how to trade this stuff, link in the description. Take advantage of my one day 75% off deflation on my swing trade and on my crypto. Not on my, crypto and the lines that I show you. Because it's National No Dirty Dish Day. So you gentlemen, make sure, you know, you're in there. Don't let Mama Bear get too mean. Look at this. Look at this perfect. This was a Head and Shoulders. This is what I've been waiting for. Here, let me carry it. You want to know why I have that little gray box zone? That's actually a target buy zone. And actually, yesterday I showed you. I got to head over to the S&P 500. And I tried to show you how to do this, okay? This is your left shoulder up here, okay? All right, right there, okay? Now we have head right there. We have little baby. Little baby right shoulder up there. And then we got right there and should be done. Well, you're actually not done until it turns all green. Then you go. And then you can measure here. Right up here, right there. That was about right. Right there. Okay, you see it? It's all measured moves. So I can head over to my little 401k or 403, whatever you guys have, just paper trade, your paper, and I move it all. Now these are accumulation zones. Do I think it's gonna go lower? There's a probability of yes. You wanna know where my no-no zone go is? Right there. There is your bear market zone. That's your S&P 500. And it's gone, look at that. How was that bounce? I said, you're going to get a bounce. And that's it. That is all it gave us right up there. But also to fix this, just to let you know, we need lots of dollars. Okay. We need lots of Fed go burr. We need lots of bonds. Okay. We just have to go so in debt because debt is money, which I know it's horrible. It's evil, but that's the system that I have been dealt with. I just play it. That's it. Also one more line. So, you know, you have that blue line, that's your bear market zone. But then you have another one, that's a trend line, which we're probably gonna break both of them at the same time. Also, let me turn on another line for you. That's that blue one, that's your 200-day moving average. Do I think we're gonna get above that? It's in the cards, okay? You really have to dig for them. Like the other day, I'm like, here's an inverted, right? There is a probability that it could play out. I just like to give you those probabilities. Also, see that brown area? Oh, should have taken profit right there. That's green area. Those are lows. And yes, this is all in the course. On this one, this is Lux Algo. Link in the description if you just want these indicators. But if you're in my swing trading course, I give you the code that you could plug in. See this red line? And it comes with the buy. It'll say buy, sell. But you really don't need that. I mean, after a while, you could see it like right here. Let me zoom in on this. This was actually a possible buy. See that little green bar that got its neck over that? The only problem is there just wasn't confirmation. I mean, if you really wanted to jump the gun, you could have. Let me show you this on this last. This was a swing trade, the last one. Yes, you can swing going down and make money going down. You make money going up, you make money going down. Here was, you see these two lines? They cross exactly. You see these two lines? They cross not. They did not cross. There is no confirmation. Do you see a little green bar? I don't either. Do you see a green bar? I do. This was your swing up. And how much was made on this one? I'm going to measure it somewhere in the thick of the candle. I mean, 5% to the time you're like, bye-bye. And also, for those of you in the comments section that with your little fingers, right? Maybe they're big fingers. I don't know. That you're like, bravo, when's the market's going to crash? The market never crash. It falls downstairs. Actually, I lied. Usually, you're like, wow, it's so dark. I know, because I got to show you the elevator. And here's me getting in the elevator. See? There. See? You get in. You take the market down as an elevator. Yes. That's me trading. You see, we usually take the escalator. That's that guy right there, up, right? And then usually, like behind me, yes, we take. Hold on. We take the elevator, which is a lot faster than the escalator. Also, in regards to you, just to let you guys know, the S&P and Experian, you got Experian, TransUnion, and Equifax. They all look at your digits and they go, "Are you trustworthy or not?" Your consumer credit default, oopsies, I said this is gonna happen. Indices show fifth straight increase, okay? Five defaults in a row of increases. And how did I know this was gonna happen? Well, because of the charts, your savings. Here, let me cast for myself. See that little blue line down there? Yeah, that's nothing. You have emptied your savings account. But then everyone's like, oh, look, people are spending more. No, they're not. Well, yes, they are. They're spending more on their credit cards. That's what we saw. So if you want to see the chart of the credit cards, it looks like this, just bass ackwards. Well, that is until they start defaulting. It's just the way the system is. And then you ask me, but how long and when crash? And I say, I don't know, but I just don't want you losing an entire life or a decade or 30 years. Don't think that these things can't last for a very long time, especially when you're like, wow, I can't believe how much the stock market went up, right? Now people are going to go, wow, I can't believe how much the stock market has went down and stayed down. This could be a lost decade for stocks. And I follow a guy that's really big on Elliott Wave, and he was saying if markets cross that, it could be like 5 years. Maybe 10 years. I don't know. You do that. I can't do the Elliott Wave. Someone just emailed me and I'm like, I don't know. I suck at Elliott Wave. If you get one number or one letter off, you're like, oh, huh, it's all gone. See, for me, I know what I know and I'm good at swing trading. When you do it long enough, you're just like, blindfold me. Okay, buy, sell. But I can also tell you that I think it's right about there. That is probably the percentage that you are going to lose in this next bear market. I mean, if you were to count percentages over the last umpteen bear markets, that's about the loss from here, the tippy top, all the way down here. So it's basically, we're back to start. And also, oh my gosh, you subscribed. Thank you so much. You did that one too. Also, I just don't want you, so make sure you get the knowledge. If you're like, I don't know what I'm doing. I lost out on the last run. Okay, well, there's going to be another one. You don't want to lose off on this run down, okay? Because there's money to be made going down, and there's money to be made going up. You just have to know how to do it. So pretty please, with sugar on top, take advantage of my 75% off link in the description, and do not leave a dirty dish in the sink, and I will see you tomorrow.